Good morning, everybody. My greetings on the occasion of Gandhi Jayanti. We are in the process of culmination of the celebration that we are having for 150th birth anniversary. And now, because today this subdued celebration is because of the COVID-19, otherwise we had great plans. So I will now request Dr. Swati Kulkarni, the Consul General, to please come and address us on this occasion. Thank you.
Hi, Sasim ji. Very good morning to all of you. Honorable guest, Mayor Dale Holness of Broward County. Esteemed dignitaries from Gandhi USA Foundation, eminent other dignitaries and participants, my colleagues from consulate. Warm greetings to all of you on the occasion of celebration of 151st birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. In 2019, you all of know that we celebrated a year-long activities marking 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, 90th birth anniversary of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and 60th anniversary of Dr. Martin Luther King's visit to India, which he famously called as pilgrimage to India. Today we are culminating all these activities and we are doing it virtually thanks to COVID. In early 2020, this year, we saw sad demise of Honorable Congressman John Lewis. He was champion of civil rights, non-violence, and he was also following Gandhian values and philosophy. We mourn his loss. He, like Mahatma Gandhi, his legacy will continue to endure and inspire all of us. Mahatma Gandhi is icon of India, father of our nation. Popularly, we call him Bapu. He was born in India, but he does not belong to India. His voice, his name, it resonates across all continents. And he is one of the most influential Indian of 20th century. He led us to freedom. He urged us to cherish and preserve it. He also urged us to cherish and preserve universal peace. And that's why UN has declared 2nd October as International Day of Nonviolence. Mahatma Gandhi is a multifaceted personality. He is not only a nationalist figure, he is also an international figure. He is a political leader, spiritual mentor, and he is also a writer, thinker, and activist. Not only he believed in India's traditions and civilization, but he also was an eager revolutionary for transformation of our social landscape. So he's not merely a figure of the past. He is a guide for our better today, and he's a shining example of our better tomorrow. Some way or another, you can see Gandhi's philosophy in India's national policies, India's foreign relations, India's development and diplomacy. Gandhi's principles are also seen in our developmental experience. We have seen pre-COVID era, India emerging as the fastest world economy, and post-COVID, we are expected to recover very fast. So our sense of achievement, what we can see that it is evident when we have seen India becoming pharmacy of the world, where we have given cost-effective drugs, which are high quality to many countries, also the vaccines. And we have also provided at the same time National Health Protection Mission to 500 million Indians, which is the biggest universal health program of what we have implemented in India for the underprivileged. Our sense of achievement is also there when we are building roads and highways, bullet trains, and sending moon mission. But at the same time, when we are giving electricity, water, house to everybody, so we are moving briskly towards elimination of poverty. And at the same time, we are also moving on international level to poise, to shape up India as some country where we are also following sustainable developmental goals. We are also taking part at the International Solar Alliance level and things where we are shaping agenda at the global level. So let us pause a bit, reflect on Gandhian principles, philosophy, his life, his work. And this exercise will undoubtedly help us in managing our opportunities, our challenges in a better way. So such people never die, they live in their achievements. So please reflect on this, and his timeless message will make our world a better place to live in. Jai Hind. Thank you. So may I now invite Honorable Mayor. Nice to see you, Mayor, here. Thank you.
Good seeing you also. Thank you so much for joining, for allowing me to join. Dr. Swati Kulkarni, Consul General for India, honored guest, and the world. Good morning and namaste. We joined together today to celebrate the life of one of the greatest human beings that ever walked the face of the earth. Not because he commanded armies or led great kingdoms, but because he served people and gave everything he had to make the world a better place for us, all of us. Mahatma Gandhi changed the world, and the world is a better place because he lived. And we are all truly grateful for that. He demonstrated that through peace and nonviolence, you can defeat mighty armies. And he did that. The power of his philosophy will live forever. This great country, America, it was made a better place because of Gandhi. Not directly, but certainly indirectly, because of what he did and what he taught the world. That a great leader like Martin Luther King and John Lewis would take that philosophy up and put themselves on the line to create opportunities for our country to become better, to ensure that we have fairness and justice and peace and tolerance demonstrated in our country. And we'll always come back to the philosophy of Gandhi, that one of love, one of sacrificing yourself for the greater good of all humanity. We're truly grateful for Gandhi. And today I'm happy that you invited me for Gandhi's Gayanti. Thank you, and God bless you all. And we'll continue to lift Gandhi and his philosophy up high and follow those principles of love, peace, understanding, tolerance, and preserving our environment. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Carolyn Bordeaux, running for Congress in Georgia's 7th Congressional District. I want to thank Subhash Razdan with the Gandhi Foundation and Consulate General Swati Kulkarni for inviting me to speak to you at Mahatma Gandhi's 150th birthday. One of Gandhi's biggest lessons is be the change you want to see in the world. He inspired so many people, including George's own Martin Luther King Jr., to choose peace and nonviolence, to be the change he wanted to see during the civil rights movement. The teachings of Martin Luther King and Gandhi continue to inspire me and so many others. Now, we need change in this country, and I'm encouraging everyone watching this to go out and to vote. Request your absentee ballot now, or go early and vote on October 12th through November 3rd, Election Day. Change is in your hands. Thank you.
Hello. Good morning, everybody. Greetings. Actually, it's a beautiful morning there, probably one of the best in the world right now in Atlanta. But thank you, Consul General Swati and your staff for the invitation to Gandhi Foundation to participate in today's solemn services and homage to Gandhiji. I'd like to recognize my colleague from Gandhi Foundation, Anthony Thaliot. If you could raise your hand, please, his presence here. And thank you for coming by here. Before leaving my home, I happened to read the message from India's Prime Minister, Narendra Modi ji, and he wrote beautifully well and paid lovely tributes to Gandhi ji and Sri Lal Bahadur Shastri, It's his birth anniversary as well today. As we reflect, as our constitutional mentioned about reflection, India was very fortunate to have these two icons of global peace, with Gandhiji as an embodiment of nonviolence and truth, and Shastriji, Lal Bahadur Shastriji, as an embodiment of sacrifice. So it is my honor and pleasure and privilege to be here and celebrate with you all. Thank you, and appreciate the invitation. Thank you.
Thank you, Subhashji. Now we come to the end of the program. And have snacks now. Please.